Hey everyone, welcome to ApogeeEdge 4-Minute Videos for Developers, Season 25, Episode 7. In this episode, we're going to find an answer to the most common question asked when it comes to API caching: what if data changes in the backend? Myself, Anil Sagar, I work at Google and Apogee platform. Prerequisites for this video, you need to understand basics of API caching as well as Apogee cache resources. For that, you can refer earlier 4-Minute Videos. As you know, ApogeeEdge sits in between the client and target system, where it can able to create API proxies and cache the data in the response. Once it is cached, ApogeeEdge can able to give back the response directly from the cache, therefore reducing the response times as well as scaling the APIs. Let's say if the data changes in the backend and you would like to flush the cache in ApogeeEdge for that particular entry. You can able to do that using ApogeeEdge management APIs, where every functionality is exposed as an API, including clearing the cache. So your backend system can able to make an ApogeeEdge management API call, deletes the cache entry in ApogeeEdge for that particular cache key, so that next call will go all the way to the backend and get the latest data. Let's see it in action, how it works. We're going to create a simple API proxy to demonstrate same. Click on API proxies, click on plus proxy button, create a new proxy, choose reverse proxy, click on next. I'm gonna give the proxy name as Books API. Make sure the proxy base path is always unique. Let's say /v1/books. Give the existing API to the Google Books endpoint. Click on next. Choose authorization pass-through. Choose next. Build and deploy. Once API proxy is deployed, let's enable the caching by attaching the response cache policy. Click on the API. Click on develop. Select preflow. Click on plus step on top of the request. Choose response cache policy and click on add. One of the important thing you need to remember is to be able to clear the cache using management API, you need to define the cache resource. Let's add cache resource. Let's call the cache resource as books cache, and we need to create this cache resource. Let's create a cache resource. To create a cache resource, click on admin, click on environments, choose the environments test, and let's create the books cache. Click on edit. So let me add a new cache called books cache and click on save. Once you create a cache resource, go back to their API and click on save. Once API proxy is saved, let's see it in action. Click on trace, start the trace session, and make few API calls. Let's say Q is equal to Node.js. By default, the cache expiry time is 1 hour, and the data is cached for 1 hour in ApogeeEdge platform. Let's say if something changes in the backend, now you want to clear the cache within 1 hour. Let's see how to do that using management API. As you can see, the data is all cached. We're going to clear the cache using management API. We're going to use Postman to make a management API call. And you can find everything about this management API call in ApogeeEdge docs. As you can see, it's a post call. We are making an API to apogeeenterprise.apogee.com/v1/organizations. Let's update the organization name. Organization name is my ApogeeEdge org name. As you can see, APAC SG partner 04. So I'm taking this org name and I'm changing this particular variable. Similarly, change environment to text test. That's where our API is deployed. Cache name is books cache, and cache key, you can get it from the trace window when you click on the response cache policy. As you can see, there is a cache key. Let's copy the cache key. You need to URL encode before you can use it in the API. So I'm gonna use the URL encode decode service. So put in the cache key and encode it and copy it once it is encoded. And we're going to replace it in the cache key section. Action is equal to clear. Just provide the basic auth as an authorization and give your ApogeeEdge username and password and click on update request. You need to add a header, content type, application octet stream, and our API is good to go. Before we make an API call, let's quickly check out the cache API. As you can see, I switched on the trace again. If I make a Node.js call, as you can see, since the cache is actually valid for 1 hour, all the requests are coming from the cache. Let's flush the cache using a management API call. Go back to the Postman and make an API call. As you can see, 200 okay, that means cache has been cleared. Let's go and test it in the trace. So I'm in the trace, I'm gonna make an API call. Now it should go all the way to the backend. As you can see, it went all the way to the backend because we cleared the cache using the management API. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you are evaluating ApogeeEdge, you can reach out to us using this link. If you have any questions, please feel free to post your questions in commit.apogee.com. Please spread the love for APIs by sharing this video with your friends and colleagues and help us spread the knowledge. You can also subscribe to YouTube channel and get notified if any future video.